Alright, so this is a McLean Edger. Let's just see down here, 8013RP9. So I bought this secondhand, Lord, 5-6 years ago, quite a while back now. And it's from 1993, and it has a little 3-horse Briggs side shaft engine on it. And I used it the other day, and I got to thinking, I said, you know, I've never changed the oil in this thing. Now, this thing gets used about, at the most, twice a year, maybe 3 times. I usually, in all honesty, I usually do it at the beginning of the season here at the house, and I'll haul it down to Mama's if needed, and use it there. Though I haven't had to do that the past couple of years, I've been able to edge everything with the weed whacker, because the grass has been a little more cooperative down there, I guess. Anyhow, this thing, I've never had it apart. I've never had trouble with it starting. You know, the older small engines were way less sensitive to ethanol, bad gas. I've never opened a carburetor on this thing, and like I said, for using it for, you know, once or twice a year, you know, it stays in the old back shed back there most of the time, and it always starts right up. You know, spray a little carb cleaner in the throat and to give it a little kick, and if I have to, drain the old gas out, and she's okay. So she's actually running on the gas in here. I cleaned the tank out before I used it this year. I kind of rinsed it out. It had some crap in the bottom. I didn't go nuts trying to de-rust the inside of the tank, because, well, it is what it is. I'll cross that bridge one day if I have to come to it. But notice the oil's a little low in her. And I think it's time for a change. I am going to add, since it is low, and I want to warm it up before I do this, I'm going to add a little bit of hydraulic oil into it, just to kind of clean it a bit, almost like a bit of a flush. And I have a little bit of Dexter on here. I don't have anything I own anymore that takes Dexter on. So I'm going to put a little bit of this in there and run it for a little while, let it warm up, and then drain it. Alright, well, this one, my finger out the way. Well, this one took a little bit of convincing to get the drain plug loose. You can see the pipe plug down here. This is a 3/8 wrench that fits this one. But you can see where it is. Of course, you know, I look to see, and a lot of the guys showing oil change videos on these and all, they show these engines bare. Well, let's let it all run. Let it all run into my shed. That's good. So maybe I had it a little over full there, putting that hydraulic oil in, but get it all nice and cleaned out. And now it's going to drip everywhere but where it should. So whatever. Welcome to working on lawnmowers. So I'll let that drain for a little while. And they say to fill it back up. There's no dipstick in these older motors. They say to fill it back up to where it starts getting on the bottom of the internal threads for the oil level check there. They got one back there and one up here. So great. Well, everything's gonna fall over on me today. I got a pogo stick. So I think about everything is out of there that's gonna come out of there, really. I think that's good enough. Now I gotta clean up a little mess here. Alright, so got my funnel in there. From what I've read, these old Briggs take about 16 ounces of oil. Originally came with non-detergent 30 weight. There's a lot of discussion on what to put in these. Kind of a Ford versus Chevy thing. You know, I have several cases of this 1040 left over from when Napa discontinued it some years back, and in fact it's even got a little, it's official motor oil of the Napa car, whoever the hell that was. But anyhow, honestly, for many years I've run a 1030 or 540 Mobil 1 synthetic in the mowers, and that all started because I was changing the oil in one of my old mowers years ago, and I happened to have half a quart of Mobil 1 540 left over from when I closed the old parts house, the old CarQuest, and man, that mower ran better than ever on that stuff. I mean, it was really a noticeable difference. And from then on, I always ran Mobil 1 in the mowers. And that's 16 ounces in there. Trying to see. I don't think the oil is quite, is the oil up to the threads? I think so. It sure is. So the oil's up to the bottom of the threads. And it's 16 ounces, and I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to leave it there. Of course, this isn't the original throttle cable on this guy, so make sure the choke is out a bit, and you ought to fire right up. Might need to choke out a little bit. Girl attention. I wish all my damn lawn equipment had one of these. Just a trouble-free, no BS, always starts and runs. You know, I was thinking back on it. I did change the oil once when I first bought this machine. So you figure, I think it was 6 or 7 years ago, honestly. So, 6 or 7 years ago, used twice a year. So yeah, it's all right. No big deal. She's got some fresh oil in her now, and like I said, for as often as I run it, she's good for another few years. I'm gonna put some grease in these fittings here. I've never done that. And I gotta find some nuts for those bolts, because two of the bolts that hold the engine to the frame are loose. And we also lost, I gotta take this one off, go down to the hardware store and match it, because we also lost the other bolt on this guard, so it's just flopping around. Well, not bad. 93 to 2013, that's 30 years. And now, I guess I really ought to change the oil in that mower. It's 2 years old. Seen a lot more runtime than this little guy. Alright.